What is a multidimensional scaling? Multidimensional scaling is a scaling technique where we want to understand or reduce the numerous variables into lesser number of variables. Similar to the data reduction techniques like cluster analysis, factor analysis, principal component analysis, multidimensional scaling is another technique. I take a very simple example. I want to manufacture chocolates. So I take 6 different types of chocolates, A, B, C, D, E, and F. And I ask different people to taste those chocolates, right? But what is my limitation? My factory can prepare only 2 types of chocolates. So out of the 6 type of chocolates that exist, I have to select only 2 types. What would be the criteria to select that? So I ask all of the candidates that I have here to taste those chocolates. And I ask them, how similar do you find? If you find them very similar, rate them on a score of 1 to 10. Okay, 1 means they are very similar. 10 means they are totally dissimilar, right? So what we do is A, A, B, B, C, C, D, D, E, E, and F, F, there is no relation. So A to B, it's very similar, I say 1. A to D, it is very dissimilar, I say 10. And B to C is okay similar, I say 3. And so on and so forth. So I fill all the values which are given in the various sets here. Now what would happen? The most interesting thing, what are these values based on? These values are based on various hidden components. This could be my taste for the chocolate. I like dark chocolate, white chocolate, flavored chocolate. I like chocolates with nuts. So that could be one criteria. The other criteria would be how big the chocolate is, how beautifully it is decorated, what is the shape of the chocolate. So there could be numerous things based on which I can say the chocolates look similar or they look dissimilar. But since this data is collected from numerous people, what we do is now I try to reduce this multidimensional data. So first, I would try to do it on a one-dimensional space. But as I would see, I can keep A and B close together. But A has to be very far from D because A and D are 10. But on the same hand, B has to be very close to C, but I could have C and D very, very close. I can say they are very correlated, C and D. So C can be correlated with D very closely, but in this case of one dimension, this cannot be possible. So I do a two-dimensional study where I say A and B are closely related. C is closely related to D, but D is far from A. So there could be a distribution which could be more pronounced in a two-dimensional space. So under a multidimensional scaling, what I can do is I can try for one dimension. If it does not fit on one, I would try for two. If it even does not fit on two, I would try for three-dimensional space, four-dimensional space, and so on. But what I'm doing is I'm exploring how many dimensions I can use. So I would start initially with one dimension, two, three. You can use softwares for the same, but the idea is exploratory. So the most important thing that we identify now is understand the distances, right? So we understand how far the things are, and based on that, we would decide that further. Now, next important thing that we are taking into account is a multidimensional scaling. As I said, it talks about distance. So it says how dissimilar the two things are. Now, if I want to manufacture only 2 types of chocolate, I would preferably select the chocolates which are very, very far rather than the chocolates that are very close, right? Now, as it is based on dissimilar aspects, differentiating variables are taken into account. On the other hand, as we had seen in our previous lecture on factor analysis, we talked about the underlying variable, the hidden factors, right? So that's again a major difference where we do multidimensional scaling versus where we do factor analysis. I hope this was an introductory explanation to it. The detailed lectures on the statistics are available in the link below. Follow those. Have a wonderful day ahead.